Hello everyone, today you will study about the singular value decomposition procedure for any matrix A, and such type of the transformation is helpful for the data compression techniques in the computer system. Before going into the detail, let's say we are having a matrix A of the order m cross n, and the rank of this matrix is equal to R. Then there exists a matrix sigma of the order m cross n and a matrix U with the order m cross m and a matrix V with the order of n cross n, such that A is splitted into U, sigma and V transform. Alright, and sigma is basically a diagonal matrix D, where you will write all the singular values of the given matrix in the diagonal, and the rest of the entries of that diagonal matrix will be zero. Alright, and you need to just determine how much number of rows and the columns of these zero entries. So m minus r represents the rows of zeros, the number of zeros, zero rows you need to introduce, and similarly n minus r columns are the number of zeros columns that you need to introduce in this sigma matrix. So I will start with an example. Let's say we are given a matrix A and I want to find its singular value decomposition. The matrix is 1, minus 2, 2, minus 1, 2, minus 2. The first step is to find the A transpose A. Okay, and the A transpose of this matrix is 1, minus 2, 2, minus 1, 2, minus 2. And A is equal to 1, minus 2, 2, minus 1, 2, minus 2. When you will multiply these two matrices, the resultant is equal to 9, minus 9, minus 9 into 9. So this is the A transpose A matrix. The next step is to find the eigenvalues of this A transpose A matrix, and we can find it by solving this equation, as you already know from the previous lectures. So we will have 9 minus lambda minus 9 minus 9 and then 9 minus lambda, and you just need to find the determinant of this above matrix. You can solve it simply, 9 minus lambda whole square minus 9 whole square is equal to 0. And when you will solve it, this characteristic equation, you will find two roots of that will correspond to the eigenvalues, that is equal to lambda 1 is equal to 18 and lambda 2 is equal to 0. So these are the eigenvalues of A transpose into A. Next step is to find the eigenvectors. So let's suppose V1 and V2 are the corresponding eigenvectors to these eigenvalues. For lambda 1 is equal to 18, let's just find the V1. So 9 minus 18 minus 9 minus 9, 9 minus 18. Alright, once you have formed the augmented matrix, then you don't need to write it down. So just mistakenly, you can ignore it. When you will solve it, you will have minus 9, minus 9, minus 9, minus 9. And in this place, you will have 0, 0. Now just apply the Gauss elimination, according to which R2 minus R1 will give you the will give you this form of the matrix, minus 9, minus 9, and both these entries of this row will be equal to 0. Now you have minus 9v11 minus 9v22 is equal to 0, or you can also write it as minus v11 minus v22 is equal to 0, or v11 is equal to minus v22. So let's say v22 is equal to minus 1, and hence you will get v11 is equal to 1. So the first eigenvector corresponding to lambda is equal to 18, is equal to 1 minus 1. All right. Similarly, for lambda is equal to 0, you will get 9 minus 9 minus 9 and then 9, 0, 0. Again, apply the Gauss elimination, and the step is R2 plus R1 that you need to perform on the above matrix. So 9 minus 9 minus 9. Okay, it will be 0. This entry will also be equal to 0. And you will left with just first row. You will get 9v21 minus 9v22 is equal to 0. On further simplification, you will get v21 is equal to v22. If v22 is equal to 1, then v21 is also equal to 1. So my second eigenvector is equal to 1, 1. And the first one was equal to 1, minus 1. Let's just orthogonalize these two vectors. Vt is the matrix of the orthonormal vectors. So when you will orthonormalize these two vectors, so v1 will be equal to 1 by under root 2, and it will be equal to minus 1 by under root 2. Similarly, v2 is equal to 1 by under root 2 and then 1 by under root 2. Okay, from the previous discussion, as I had mentioned, the order of V should be 2 cross 2 or n cross n with the number of the columns. So we have determined here over the value of matrix V. Now let's just find the order of the matrices of sigma and U. So the order of the sigma is same as that of the original matrix A, and that was equal to 3 cross 2. So the order of the sigma is equal to 3 cross 2, and the number of columns and the rows of zeros are determined by using the formula n minus r and n minus m that I mentioned previously. So the order of the sigma will be equal to, sigma is equal to d0 0, 0, 0, 0, and in place of the diagonal, we have to write down the square root of eigenvalues. So sigma 1 is equal to under root of lambda 1, and sigma 2 is equal to under root of lambda 2. All right. So under root 18, which is equal to 3 under root 2, while under root of 0 is equal to 0. So here sigma will be equal to 3 under root 2 and then 0, 0, 0, and here we will get 0 cross 0. This is my matrix sigma. Now the last task is to find U, and how the U is composed of. U matrix is found by finding the rules of AV1 and AV2. Alright, so first of all we need to find AV1, and AV1 was equal to A minus 1 minus 2, 2, 2 minus 2. And what is V1? V1 was the first eigenvector, that is equal to 1 minus 1. When you will multiply it with this, you will get AV1 comes out to be 2 divided by under root 2, more 4 divided by under root 2, 4 divided by square root of 2. Similarly, when you will multiply A with the second eigenvector, you will get it becomes equal to 0. So you can continue this procedure until you find all the eigenvectors of this matrix. There is a little problem with that. The only non-zero vector u1 that you have found so far is equal to av1, and av2 is equal to 0. Also, from the given information, u should be of the order of 3 × 3, and so far we have found a single single vector u1. So u1 is basically is equal to 1 over sigma 1 into a1 v1. So u1 is equal to, here you can you will divide 1 divided by 3 under root 2 with this vector 2 over under root 2 minus 4 divided by under root 2, 4 divided by under root 2, and it will be equal to 1 by 3 minus 2 by 3 and then 2 by 3. The rest of the vectors of u can be found by solving the equation u1 transpose into x is equal to 0. The case would have been easier if the value, the eigenvectors or the product of a1 v1 was not equal to 0. But in such type of the case, you can continue the same procedure for finding the u1, u2, u3. I mean to say u2 would have been equal to 1 by sigma 2 into a1 v2. And similarly, u3 could have been found by 1 divided by sigma 3 a1 v3. If you had 3 distinct eigenvalues and the eigenvectors. But now the scenario is the rest of the product is equal to 0. So that's why you will first find u1 transpose into x, and this is equal to x1 minus 2x2 plus 2x3 is equal to 0. And now you will find the basis for the solution set of this vector, and this is equal to w1 is equal to 210, and similarly w2 is equal to minus 201. These both vectors are orthogonal to each other. You just need to normalize these two vectors that will result into u1 and u2 and u3. So u2 is equal to 2 divided by under root 5. I mean to say you have divided the vector by its magnitude. Similarly, 1 divided by under root 5 and 0. Similarly, u3 is equal to minus 2 divided by under root 45, 4 divided by under root 45, and then 5 divided by under root 45. So the matrix A has been converted into 1 by 3 minus 2 by 3, 2 by 3. Similarly, 2 divided by under root 5, 1 divided by under root 5, 0. Minus 2 divided by under root 45, 4 divided by under root 45, and then 5 divided by under root 45. Similarly, 3 under root 2, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and then you will write here V. I am writing it over here. 1 divided by under root 2 minus 1 divided by under root 2, 1 by under root 2, and then 1 by under root 2. So in this way, a matrix A is decomposed into U, sigma, and VT. Thank you for watching.